Hello and welcome to Team Fortress TV. We are back with some ETF2L. Coming up this evening, we're going to be taking a look at 3 out of 6 versus Lemmings. This is Premiership Season 26, Week 6. Our maps this week will be Granary and Gullywash. But my name is Frisk, and I'm joined by the one and only Turbo Tabs on the mic, and we have Jem on production this evening. Turbo, how you doing?
Yeah, doing okay, man. Doing okay. I've hibernated a couple of days ago, but I've come back fresh as a daisy. I'm ready to watch some TF2.
Likewise. And this one, maybe not the closest match we've seen so far this season. It will be a Lemmings versus 3-6, as I've said. And I think we're coming kind of to the tail end of the season here, Turbo. It's hard to say if 3-6 will be able to put up some sort of fight, especially considering on Sunday, I believe, Lemmings did play Champ GG, and we saw a very close game, maybe closer than some expected. We saw Lemmings take a map. They took Gullywash against Champ GG, but I think nonetheless, we are in for some more TF2 action.
Yeah, we just have to take in those words first. It just seems so strange to say them out loud. Me personally, when going into the season, I thought 3 out of 6 would have a bit of a breakout season, but they've been hitting some snags and bumps, and they've ended up resorting to off-classing for the majority of their leftover season. Meanwhile, Lemmings just seem to be getting better and better with every match. I just didn't think it would happen. I thought they would have a rough start of a season as they crept in. I think they were the final team to get into Prem as well. But yeah, the fact that they took a map off of Champ GG, they've proved to everybody that this is not just a rocky season for them. This is a season that's going to show a lot of growth for them.
Yeah, absolutely. Certainly a lot of improvement we've seen. And this, I suppose, has just culminated in the match we saw the other day against Champ GG. So I think Lemmings certainly will be feeling good going into this game. I mean, Turbo, would you say you'd give it to Lemmings in this matchup?
Oh yeah, no doubt, no doubt. I mean, 3 out of 6, they are like pretty DM-centric right now, what with everybody kind of just changing to different classes. They haven't quite got the coordination or the understanding of what every single role should be doing on their team. But who knows, they might have hashed this out since then. I mean, it has been a few weeks now since they've made the swap over, and they might have gone through that team talk, but this whole class change doesn't just tell me about the playstyle. It also tells me about the attitudes of the team right now, where they probably aren't prioritizing these little sit-downs where they think, maybe we should coordinate how we're going to play out these certain maps. I think they're just going in, winging it, and enjoying themselves this season. So I'm obviously going to go vouch for the serious team over the fun team.
Yeah, for sure. I'm not sure if anybody from 3-6 will want to have some interviews after the match. Maybe they'll be able to tell us how they're finding the class changes, and if they really, I suppose, if they're having a lot more fun now that they've just switched things up. But yeah, I think Lemmings, of course, will just be running their standard lineup. But speaking of lineups, I'm just going to run down Lemmings. We have Daegu on Medic, Deox playing Doman, Domo and Pred on Soldier, and Warped and Crayon playing Scout. So Turbo, if you want to run us through the roster for Lemmings.
Yeah, and over on the side of Lemmings will be Sorex on Scout, Inns will be Scout Buddy, Zesty on the Roaming Soldier, Coldheart on the Pocket Soldier, Elicor on the Demoman, and Honey on the Medic. What a group of guys and girls.
Absolutely, and I think you should be able to vote in chat right now for the team you think will take this match. But right now, there are some stats here, Turbo, on stream. We're looking at some head-to-heads for 3 out of 6 and Lemmings. I don't know if there's any stats jumping out to you, Turbo.
The stats that are jumping out at me is maybe the main differences between the Pocket Soldiers. Domo is holding a candle above Coldheart right now. But if I was looking at other little differences as well, it goes to show that Sorex, on the other side of things, is kind of outflexing Crayon a bit on that scout role as well. So they both teams have their strengths, and it seems they're just varying from class to class.
Yeah, absolutely. I think I'll point out as well the Alicor and Deox head to head. I think Alicor has had a really fantastic season, and I mean, I suppose along with the rest of his team, he's improved quite a lot. I think he's a really, really good up and coming Dauman talent. So I think we should expect to see some more performances from him this game. But as of right now, there is the Deox and Alicor head to heads. And as you can see, average kills per map, Alicor certainly coming out on top here. But I mean, Deox taking a lot more heals as well, so that certainly, I guess, could be detrimental to 3 out of 6's success. But I think regardless, Alicor probably would have the edge on Deox.
I just want you to draw your eye, Frisk, to that damage per per minute meter. It's sitting at a 289. That's third place out of all the Demoman this season. Isn't that strange that Lemmings has got the third best Demoman in if we went by the stats at least.
Yeah, that is, I suppose. I think this is Alicor's first season of Prem. So yeah, I think certainly next season we'll see Alicor, who knows, Turbo, could rise above that third place Stellman ranking on the damage per minute.
He is a an interesting person to cast. When he's going big, he's going huge. He's very flashy in my eyes. He likes to jump in a lot, go aggressive. He reminds me of Spud back in the day, where he was a lot of flash and very impressive on stream. But whether or not he'll make the transfer all the way to like this Demoman that could do not only the flashy plays, Frisk, but I guess round it off with some defensive, because I feel like once they struggle against these really difficult teams, like these higher teams like Tut7 or maybe even like ChamGG, for example. Elocor's flashy plays kind of go like a flash in the pan, and they don't quite, pull off the same way, because both these higher teams know how to just handle him a bit better.
Yeah, absolutely. It's, I suppose, I type of demo
Oh my
play can be
God.
quite hit and miss, but
Frisk, cover your eyes. No, cover your virgin eyes. These are not anyone should see this bar of this stature. Sorex is literally not only doubled but tripled. Poor Crayon. He was. Yeah, fair. Okay, he was medic for half of the season, but I'm pretty sure these are averaged out. Okay, Twitch chat, don't you say that. Crayon should be given the benefit of the doubt here. So I think this should be based on his scout stats alone. And keep in mind, as the season went on as well, that's when Crayon and his boy should have got some easier matches in there as well. I think they got the majority of their difficult matches, like seven and whatnot, at the start. So these scout stats should be leaning more his way, if anything. And oh my God, Sorex just smashes him.
Yeah, absolutely. I think to be fair to Crayon now, this is Sorex we're talking about. You know, this is the Pasta Brain Scout, the DM Lord. So I suppose any scout matchup, you could argue Sorex would have the edge, but yeah, certainly here these stats are quite skewed in favor of Sorex, so I certainly would expect to see Sorex do a lot of work this game.
My, it is a almost an untold of ask. Let's I see another. Oh, it's Pred and Zesty, the roaming versus my favorite. Now Zesty has completely shocked me this season. He's turned out to be one of the star talents, I guess, like almost like the dark horse of the Roma class. I think he's really been impressing me so far with his Roma play. How about you, Frisk? Any
Yeah, I completely agree. Zesty has been the soldier to watch this season. I've really enjoyed casting the games that he's been playing, and I think we're seeing a bit of a trend here, Turbo. Every player on Lemmings has just I suppose maybe turned up this season and shocked us with how much they're improving. But certainly Zesty is a top player, maybe a player you could single out as a somebody who's really played pretty well this season. And I think I hope to see him play next season, and hopefully maybe overall in the tables, whatever team he's on, we'll be able to get some more points than what the Lemmings have right now. I believe they have 5 points. I think they are in sixth overall on the tables. But yeah, absolutely, Zesty has really impressed me this season.
I mean, this is all very a very shining moment for Lemmings to say that Zesty was a last minute pickup. I mean, I think they had somebody else in mind for that role, or but they just dropped out at the last minute. They have to pick up Zesty, and he's paid off well. He's just, yeah, just want to play. Want to play. I can't sing his praises enough. But there is two people on that graph. I should talk about Pred a little bit. The only one that's actually decided to stick with his class, compared to all his compadres. And Pred, I've not seen too much of Pred. That's why I only talk about Zesty so much. So maybe you could shine a light on him.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Fred, I mean, I suppose when your team is was having some like a horse 3-6 or having some troubles and they decided to just mix up the classes, it's hard to really measure exactly how well a soldier would do, but he certainly does he's consistent enough. I think he does take pretty he plays a pretty average soldier. I think he plays pocket, but yeah, he's pretty consistent, I at least from what I've seen. But
Yeah, I know that's. I've got the exact same reaction for this guy. This guy is just a complete unknown to me. He's a question mark. Maybe most of the time when I'm watching these games, I'm too busy looking at maybe Deox or Nation when he was once on there as well, and maybe a bit of Domo as well. I know Domo is a bit of a breakout player as well in my eyes, and the 3 out of 6. But Pred, I guess Pred just doesn't really jump out at me. But I've been saying that for a bit too much now. I bet he must be hate. It's full of hatred for me by now.
yeah, we might have to keep our eye on Pred this game to see if he'll prove you wrong, Turbo. But I think Pred isn't the flashiest soldier. Just plays a bit of a safer game than I suppose Zesty, as we were saying. But yeah, I mean, we'll have to see how he'll maybe affect the game in our first map, which will be Gullywash. And I mean, Turbo, do you want to give us some cheeky predictions?
Well, I think this map will come down to the roaming soldiers for both of these teams. I think it. I remember actually, yes, I did cast the Pred's last game, so I remember Pred having a pretty decent game actually. I think this. Oh wait, no, I'm thinking of Viaduct. Whoopsie. But they did lose that map last time against Nunya, so they've got a lot of ground to cover in my eyes as well if they want to win this map against the better team Lemmings. So it would be all on Pred, I believe. If he can like turn up this hugely huge on this game, then maybe he can bring the victory for his 3 out of 6 squad. But I'm still gonna go with Lemmings though. However, Zesty hype is just way too much lingering in my mind, so I'm gonna go with a close, super tight 3 out of, yeah, actually 3-2 score, 3-6 score. Let's make it for the Lemmings. So six
Yeah,
out of three,
that's
six
fair.
round.
And I mean, as much as I'd like to see, 3-6 pull something out. Obviously, anything is possible. Players can just have the games of their lives, but I think Lemmings just. I think this their last week's game. What I say last week, I think it was only a couple of days ago, maybe 1 or 2 days ago. Their win over Champ GG is certainly a very big confidence boost, and Gullywash was the map that they were able to finally really prove to everybody this season that they have what it takes to take on a strong team like Champ GG. So I really think it will be Lemmings, at least on Gullywash. I mean, we might see something different on Granary, but I think I would give it to Lemmings as well on this map.
Prisk, 3 out of 6 needs some allies on their court. I feel like we're just, picking the easy team. So I'm actually gonna change my prediction. I'm gonna go with 3 out of 6 just to be the devil's advocate.
That's fair enough.
I can't leave no man behind. No fat kids here allowed.
That's very noble of you. Support this team, support 3-6. But regardless, I am hoping we will see a close game on our first map. And yeah, I mean, we've said, I suppose we said Pred will maybe be the player who'll have to step up. If Lemmings, let's say Lemmings do, run into some trouble, I mean, who do you think will then have to? Will it be Zesty again who might have to rescue his team, or? I
I
suppose
think
Zesty and Zorax are the DM lords of Lemmings.
yeah, I believe so, but it's not. I think if Pred is winning the game, I think it'll be coming more down to Elocol, maybe what you can see, what you can do on these mids to deny some of these soldiers, maybe set up these mids a little bit better for his team. But this is just all speculation. I'm already like breaking down something that might not even happen. But if I had to think of someone who could like come in huge and just be the biggest difference maker, is probably Coldheart. I know Coldheart is I think had a somewhat timid season. She's not a lot is really demanded of her, but when she does get good games, it can only really translate to the team doing really well, because that goes to show that they're firing on all cylinders rather than just the huge couple of huge names that they have. So Coldheart can like slap out a good game as well. That would be great for the team as well.
Yeah, absolutely. But if you are just joining us, this is our first map of ETF2L Season 26 Premiership. This is our first map, Gullywash. As we see, 3 out of 6, kind of taking a lot of spam. It looks like there's more or less equal positioning here on this point. But Zesty is really the first to go down. And wow, nice pipe from Elecor picking that frag up. It looks like Pred wants to get onto Honeybadger, and he won't actually pick him up. But Demos, oh, nearly gets the pick, but he won't be able to. Crayon as well, trying to get in here, but Honeybadger somehow just dances his way around all of this damage. And I mean, it's a bit of a 3v3 at the moment, but it looks like 3 out of 6 are just going to fall back to their second.
Oh man, I was expecting some braver souls coming out in that mid there. They had 2 scouts left on 3 out of 6. I was very certain that they could still fight that, but no, they just decided to back out in the end, not really trusting themselves in their maybe in their DM regard in comparison to Coldheart and Sorex. I mean, have you seen that meter for Sorex? Has a pretty big meter.
Absolutely, but at the moment, Lemmings looking like they want to poke in here through this big door area, but Ince catching a rocket will go down. So I think at the moment, Lemmings are just gonna take a little bit of a step back and wait for their respawner. I think it doesn't look like 3 out of 6 will be able to do anything. A one-man pick isn't a lot to go off of, so at the moment we will just see a small stalemate right now, Turbo.
To spot a spy class. Oh wait, never mind. That is actually a sniper class being slapped out. Crayon was just checking what toys they're playing with over on the side of
And
Lemmings.
Ince has gone sniper as well, so we will see 2 snipers on the field. We will see the game slow down pretty much immediately. But yeah, so
Oh,
Zesty.
Zesty. Oh, he did it!
Wow, incredible. But that's going to be an easy push, surely, for Lemmings here to get into second. Ince picking up Crayon as well. It's just 3 alive at the moment for 3 out of 6. And yeah, they're going to pick up the second and surely walk this Ubercharge into last.
Yeah, it's very difficult once you lose your medic as well. It's very difficult to make a counterplay when you've got these chokes cut off, and they're Ubering in with Sorex on Scout. They're actually running the vaccinator on Ubrundigo to kind of just soak up some of this Uber. They do lose the heavy weapons guy, but in the end, that was his job to just die for the cause. And look at all the spaces allowed for his team. They can now use their soldiers to try and clean up this damage. They've picked off the majority of these players here. Honeybadger still lives though, so that's a silver lining if they can. Do anything with it though is another question.
Yeah, absolutely. Good, I suppose, good choice from Honeybadger to just leave the fight, so he will be able to start building. However, the rest of his team did die, so Degu will be coming up on a pretty big advantage here. So they will be bringing this in,
Oh,
and
it's the Elocor trap. It always gets somebody every time. I've seen him place that sticky trap on the midpoint every single time, and it seems to target Demomen. I don't know why. I guess Demomen aren't really in the habit of checking those sticky traps. It's usually down to your pockets or your scouts, I suppose.
Yeah, so Degu did opt for that vaccinator, and it didn't seem to work out too well. But I think Degu did have a pretty cool surf. He surfed onto the slanted roof above Big Door. And I think he actually managed to live. I'm not sure if he would have died if he had cratered or if he had hurt himself, but at the moment, 3-6 again are going to be back on their last, and it looks like Degu's running that minigun again. So, I mean, these Uberchargers will be equal, so I think there's no major crazy off-classes coming out. We do have the Crayon Engineer, but at the moment, it looks like both these teams will just get their Uberchargers, and they're going to see how Lemmings will be able to break down this defense.
hopefully, if lemmings are doing their work properly, they should be spotting if this sentry gun's in amok. And I think they must have been now if they heard the noises coming from the sentry gun itself. So, they should be focusing down the sentry. Yeah, you can see Coldheart now trying to spam the sentry gun, and Crayon does get back to it in time to actually heal it. I'm kind of hoping that Zesty would have coordinated with his pocket soldier there to take down the sentry gun, but instead Crayon has decided to move the sentry gun just to keep it out of harm's way from that
Zesty,
spam.
Zesty though, Zesty was in so deep onto Daegu, and he somehow managed to get him all the way back at his spawn door and pin him in the corner, so Daegu had no choice but to pop that Uber charge. So this is really good. Zesty just had a wonderful bomb there, managed to get the Uber charge out of Daegu, so Honey Badger will have this full Uber advantage to get into last.
Yeah, you even seen Sorex sneak onto the point for a moment there and draw a lot of eyes, and it looks like they want to make this push with Elecor alone. Oh, actually, Inns is going to get a bit of the love as well, but they have to deal with this sneaky sentry gun before they do any sort of pushing forward, and they've got some Vaccinator and a Heavy to deal with as well. There's just so much on their plate right now, Chris.
Yeah, absolutely, and it looks like it's worked so well. This Heavy as well, they weren't able to get enough damage on the Heavy, and another failed push from Lemmings, and it looks like Honeybadger and Sorex are just going to have to get out here and wait for the rest of their team. But 3-6, a little bit slow maybe to get out to second, but at the moment it looks like they should be able to take this point.
Yeah, because they decided to back out from that big door area, there's no real hope for them to actually branch out and make this second defense. You do see Elecor poking from the choke ever so slightly, but they will cap it under their feet, but they've just dedicated their lives to capping it in the end. And instead, if they just moved as an entire unit, try and take out one of the halves, the choke or the big door, maybe they could have turned it into a huge mid push as well, but they decided to just play greedy and go for the cap point instead.
Yeah, absolutely, and now they're in a bit of a bad situation here. Brad getting picked up as well, but he has taken down Honeybadger, so that might be the saving grace here. 3 out of 6 will have these heals to work with, and Elecor taking quite a lot of damage. He is in on this riverside, but it looks like Zesty and Coldheart have gone down too. He's running the sniper on this balcony, and he's a little bit overextended, so he will get picked up by Warp. So, wow, a really good job by, I think it was Pred who was able to pick up Honeybadger. But we see Warped just getting picked up by that sticky trap, so we'll have to see if 3-6 will be able to make it out here into second, but at the moment it looks like they're just kind of lingering around lobby.
Man, everybody died on Lemmings except the Demoman, and Demoman is all you need, baby, to defend that second point. He just threw a couple of stickies on that door, and, well, it's defended. What can you do? They've got an Uber charge, though. They could think about making the push out here, and the medic is right there. They actually are making the play. Domo is trying to find the play. He wants to go for the pocket soldier instead, and this has left Honeybadger exposed, and you see Domo, he's chasing. He needs it, but the scout has come back. Oh, no, it's Sorex as well.
Wow, and Ince as well, he's caused a bit of a distraction. I think he managed to pick up a kill there before going down, so of course we will see Honeybadger with a bit of an advantage, but I think 3 out of 6 should probably make their way into mid. I mean, what do you think about this, Chervo? Should they be trying to poke their way here, or should they just be holding second?
I think they could definitely hold second here. I think the nature of Gullywash allows it with that top area as well, but it seems the soldiers don't want to hang out with Daegu. They want to avoid him like the plague, and while they were, I guess, rotating about, they've already got a load of manpower on that point over on the Lemmings squad, so they've just basically given it away for free there, because I don't think 3 out of 6 knew what to do.
Yeah, I mean, I was thinking that even, you know, they could have looked to see if they could have gotten into mid. I think they had more players alive, but a little bit hesitant maybe about exactly what they wanted to do. But we do see this Heavy being run. Crayon as well on this Pyro has managed to buy his team a little bit of time at the moment. Finally goes down. Daegu will have a Zuba charge as well. So at the moment it's looking like 3 out of 6 are just about safe again.
They have a very early pop coming in from Daegu there. That was just one of those safety pops where you feel like, oh, I see an Uber charge, therefore I must Uber, because you've been in that scenario so many times before. But I think he could have got away with just surviving a little bit longer without having to pop it there, but maybe tried to save his Pyro buddy who was pushing everyone back. Couldn't quite reach him.
Yeah, absolutely. I have just spotted Zesty running the spy. So, I mean, Zesty does like to run spy sometimes, so you'll have to see what he'll be able to do. There is a sentry gun, Crayon building it in that sneaky corner again, and Zesty does see the sentry, so he will be relaying that information to his team. But I think, of course, When you are running a spy, generally the team will like to wait, but Zesty nearly
he
getting
the needle. Oh what? No, they spotted him.
I think he just connected a pipe somehow. Deox, that's crazy. He just hit a pipe onto Zesty and then picked up another one. So Bread and Demo as well, Bread and Domo as well getting picked up. So that's not good. But Deox, a nice sticky trap there to pick up Elicor. Deox says, "I can also lay down sticky traps." So yeah, I mean at the moment it just looks like there must be a bit of a reset. Zesty going back to Soldier. But I think Mel wants to go for some kind of play on the point. She is in water at the moment, just below this, and I don't think anybody on 3-6 is actually holding anywhere near the point, so this could be a good opportunity to do something, but do have to remember that Crayon is running this sentry gun.
She is literally just being a double agent right now, staying in the shadows and not compromising a position for anything. They're trying to make a play with Zesty and Elicor, and Coldheart's going to stand on the point during this play, and she'll just be picked off as well. I don't know what the aim of that little coordinated play was. Maybe just to throw in enough bodies to distract them and maybe get the back cap, but you're just a soldier, Frisk. You're not going to cap back cap with just that times one cap.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I have that sentry gun to deal with as well, but at the moment it looks like 3-6 want to come out here onto the second point. They have used the supercharge. And Honey Badger will hop his supercharge in turn. At the moment, there's no progress as of yet. It's going down, but we do have the respawners in here from Lemmings, and it's a really scrappy fight. There's a lot of weak players here on 3-6. But at the moment, it looks like 3-6 might be able to come up on top. Dagon's so weak, he's trying to dodge these pistol shots from Zorex, but it actually will be Honey Badger picking up that arrow kill. And it looks like Fred wants to go in and do something, but just gets demolished. Wow.
Yeah, maybe the DM just showing off a little strong for Lemmings there. It looked like 3-6 had it in the bag, but again, it goes back to these Uber pots and Dago. I feel like Honey Badger's forced his hand because he's just on a player advantage, and disadvantage, and he has to use his Uber just to keep his troops alive. But Dago could probably afford to just milk these Ubers just a little bit more and give these little advantages to the team where they could use them best.
Yeah, for sure, but Pred is onto Honey Badger at the moment. We'll get the frag, but we'll, of course, go down in turn. So, good situation, I think, right now for 3-6. They do have a supercharge, but, of course, they might be looking to push out of last, but they do have a sentry gun up. So, at the moment, it looks like they want to just stay here on this last and see if Lemmings see what their next move will be. Of course, Dagon will have quite a big advantage, so, I mean, it doesn't look like Lemmings want to run any pick classes or anything like that.
I'm going to run the scenario by you, Frisk. Let's just say it's 0-0 right now, and you've got an Uber charge advantage. You can make a push out with this. Do you make the choice? Do you dare push out, or do you just wait at last and let Lemmings make a mistake?
I think I'd be very bored at this point, so I'd probably just push out, but it looks like 3-6 want to go with this, and they have maybe heard my words as Dagu takes his Uber charge into mid, and it looks like it's Domo really far forward there with that Ubercharge, forcing the rest of Lemmings out, but it looks like Elicor and Zesty are behind in 3-6's choke, so it looks like Elicor might want to go for a block on second, but right now it looks like Domo will get picked up, so the rest of 3-6 have already made their way all the way back to their last point.
It's a shame as well, because they pushed out so many players over on Lemmings that they couldn't really defend second, they just had the Demoman there, but they just still decided to back out, calling it a bad Uber in the end, because they didn't get the magical med pick that they were looking for, and Warped has now got to do the familiar sight of dying for the cause yet again. There was a nice little heal coming out from Dagu to extend his light ever so often, and again, we're seeing in good Gullywash fashion that they're... Oh, actually, Inns is on the point, but there's two players for him to deal with, and Dagu's also keeping them very healthy as well. They're actually going to leave Crayon behind to deal with that last player and think about making the push out with those remainders.
Yeah, that's a full wipe for Lemmings. Lemmings, at the start of the fight, it was looking pretty good, but then Demo came in, and I think he picked up two kills at one rocket. I think he did a lot of damage as well, but I suppose Lemmings were focusing that heavy, but after the fight, they weren't able to pick up the frag, so at the moment, 3-6 looking to get into this mid point perhaps, but they have opted for this drop down push. At the like we see here, Dagu bringing his team in at the moment, Zesty going down, and it looks like the rest of the Lemmings are just gonna getting spammed out of choke here. But it looks like Ince and Sorex are in some weird situations behind. Ince actually will back out, but Sorex right now has dragged the rest of 3-6 behind. All of them are trying to get back here and taking out Sorex, so it's a good play from Sorex to buy some time for his team.
Yeah, and it's a bad play coming out from Crayon there, going forward without his team. Actually, followed suit by Domo, It's actually 3 out of 6 putting their best Lemmings impression, walking in the choke one by one. And maybe they'll think about defending this over on Lemmings. Oh, I like this play. Even though they've got the Uber charging, oh, Honey Badger just gets his as well. What a great series of events for Lemmings. Now they can just chase out these kills. Look at them farming them. And now Crayon's just come back from the respawn queue just to probably die again. Inns wants the kill there. He's hunting him down, but he will go all the way back to last. But
yeah, but Pred is on this midpoint. He looks like he wants to get some backup at
Elecor. But he's just
here.
A soldier. He's just a lonely little soldier. Elecor will even go back in Elecor fashion and take out that player in style as well. They've already got a few players onto last. They've just embedded a little bit of chaos, and that was all that was needed for them to get the first round on the board first.
Yeah, a 15-minute round, and the first round will go to Lemmings. It was, I mean, Pred did try for that back cap onto mid, but I think that, you know, if he had stayed behind, perhaps 3 out of 6 could have held that, but we will see these teams roll out to this second round.
Alright, the first thing I'm watching on this mid is Pred. He's going drop down, but they should know he's there already. They've dedicated Coldheart to deal with it, but Pred has decided to double down on his kind of a flank around, and he's kind of giving them the bluff whether or not, am I going behind? Am I going in front of from the behind? I don't know, but Pred will kind of keep that constant pain in the back of their minds while they're trying to blob up on mid over on Lemmings. Pred will strike now, and Crayon's trying to play off that. He will pick up Elecor. It's a big pick against the Lemmings squad, and he's tried his best.
Coldheart. Wow, Coldheart just got a really nice airshot onto Crayon. Yeah, they're going to bring the supercharge in. Daegu trying to keep his supercharge. They don't want to use this. They're going to wait for the supercharge to fade. So, yeah, I mean, it looks like Lemmings will take this mid, but Daegu will have a supercharge to work with, so we'll have to see if they'll be able to take this.
I'm a bit surprised that they didn't pop there. I thought they would do the counter pop. It looked like they were just milking it very expertly, and then Deox went down. And I think from there they just thought, it's way too risky now if this Uber will actually pan out. So they will give up the Deox kill and not pop the Uber, which I guess is a good play now that they're making this push in, but they're not using it quite aggressively as I hoped they would. They're slow pushing it out, and they're just getting three room, I suppose, and mission accomplished. But it was maybe a little bit risky, but you know, can't argue with the results risk.
Yeah, absolutely. That was, the kind of play that maybe we were expecting 3 out of 6 to see. I mean, this was expecting them to see here, like, this choice of just bringing the Uber charge in, so they still will have this Uber, but of course, maybe it might have been a better choice to use the Uber, because Honey Badger, in the meantime, did manage to build up an Uber charge, so they're going to have to take this Uber exchange. They don't have any pick classes or anything like that, so we're going to have to see how 3-6 will go ahead with this. I think this is, the first time that they have been able to contest maybe Lemming's second point, so we'll have to see. It looks like Pred wants to get in at the moment, and he will be jumping right now. And I think he might have just gone in for a little bit of a suicide, and he has, as Elecor picks up that frag. The rest of his team were kind of waiting in choke to see if he was able to maybe get the force out of Honey, so at the moment they are just going to hold.
Sad day for when you jump in and you can't even see the medic on your screen, let alone think about shooting a rocket at him. So his bomb was off or not, but you gotta try, I suppose. Pred will come back. Hopefully they'll try and make an off class, and they are sending a scout back, so it does make me think that there's gonna be a sniper. There you go! Crayon sniper. Highlander.
Yeah, I've seen Crayon run a bit of sniper, and he's played an okay sniper, but I haven't seen any huge plays, but it looks like he's wanting to peek this choke at the moment, but I mean, Turbo, this running a sniper, trying to push into a second can be pretty difficult to get an angle. I mean, this choke is really difficult to get any sort of angle onto Honey Badger, especially, you know, when Lemmings are holding so far forward. It's so easy to put spam to deny a sniper, but it looks like the rest of his team are trying to get him some space here. Zesty going down on that big door area, so we'll have some more space to work with here, and it looks like Domo wants to get in there onto Honey Badger, but won't be able to pick that up, so at the moment, Crayon still up this big door area, trying to find something. But two players down here, one for each team, so at the moment it's kind of on back to this stalemate situation.
Yeah, the sniper is a bit of a question mark. I'm not sure if he can really find the pick they want to do. There really has to be some sort of sync play where he's watching the big door area and kind of maybe using the rest of his team to force the choke area to make them push back a bit if they really want to push the Honey Badger kill. Otherwise, they're just going to have to be content with a scout or a soldier on the big door area and then trying to make a push off that. But then that's kind of counterintuitive because you kind of think, I've got this sniper and I want to push. That's not really the go-to pushing method in the TF2 book.
Oh, well, there we go. Finally getting that pick onto Elicor. Domo, though, goes down as well. I think they wanted to send him for a follow-up, but I mean, it's hard to say if they'll be able to do anything with that. Of course, the Domo pick is pretty big, but, it looks like they still want Crayon to get something else. I think Pred and Zesty were having a small duel on the flank, but the spawner will come up here from Elicor. I mean, Turbo, do you think at this point you'd want to see some kind of maybe spy play come out here, 3 out of 6, or do you think they might just have to take the supercharge in and hope for the best?
I think if they're not going to push off the Demoman pick that they got with Crayon, I don't know what they're possibly waiting for with this sniper, so they need to... It looks like they're deciding to go a bit more aggressive on the big door area. This is a lot better!
There is the pick they were waiting for, and Daegu will use his supercharge, SD and Inskai down as well, so it is just Coldheart and Sorex. Coldheart behind in this choke area, and they will be capping the second. They're already taking this into last. It's just Sorex and Domo and Daegu just want to take this in, but they will have some spawners, so at the moment they will have an uber advantage to work with, and that's exactly what they wanted from Crayon, and that's perfect for them. This is their first opportunity here for them to take a round.
Alright, bear with me, Frisk. I'm just going to write on my whiteboard here, just, you know nothing about Team Fortress 2. There we go, let me just dot that. Okay. Now that I've been swiftly reminded by Crayon and his buddies, he will actually be cleaned up by Zesty, but that's just a trade. He will go down for the cause, and it's time for them to meet up against the soldier. I mean, the heavy weapons guy, he was deleted so quickly that I didn't really have a chance to call what class he was. You do have Deox committing fully to the last point, but they've got their own demo man to deal with that. Elicor will be traded out there, and it's just Crayon left, and he's decided to come back as spy. Maybe a back cap, but that'll be an incredibly great... Oh, wait,
oh, it gets never mind. Yeah, that was a bit unfortunate for 3 out of 6. That was a really good chance. They did manage to pick up that heavy early on, but they did take a lot of damage, so...
In scout, he's behind. He's drawing a lot of eyes as well. He's even going to survive. Okay, I'm going to look back at the whiteboard. Don't know anything about Team Fortress 2. Okay, we're going...
Fadeaway pipe from Deox puts him down, but at the moment Lemmings will pick up this midpoint, and Daegu of course will have an advantage, so we'll have to see if Lemmings want to try and do something here. They pretty much, it's a reversed situation as we just had a few minutes ago. Lemmings want to get in the second, so we'll have to see if they'll run a sniper or spy just like Crayon was really patient and did end up picking up that fragment of the honey. So, I mean, at the moment it looks like they're just going to run the standard lineup.
Seems Daegu and Co aren't prioritizing their uber building, so it makes me believe they don't... Well, they are pushing off it, so they do know that they have an advantage, but they're kind of slow pushing it out, and every second that ticks by, Honey Badger's getting a bit closer, and last time it got into this situation, they got wiped and lost a round, Frisk, so hopefully they will actually pop off the uber in the end, but Honey Badger just kind of laughs from the balcony. Oh, I have got no danger upon me. So he's going to hold on to his uber and just think about making the second push in. It looks like they're posturing that they've given up second as well. So 3 second point, 3 uber, 3 everything. Looking back at the whiteboard, don't know anything. Okay.
Yeah, absolutely. Fred is behind mid at the moment. I'll have to wait to see if he will be able to do anything. He has been spotted by Sorex, so... meanwhile, it looks like Lemmings might go through the shutter area. They have a supercharge. They're gonna bring this in. They do have Crayon on this Pyro, doing a good bit of work denying this, but will get picked up, so they do have a good opportunity here. They push the rest of the team back into spawn, and they're gonna play this point. But we do see Pred coming back in here onto Honey Badger. He will get the frag, and it looks like it's just Elicor and Mel alive. They're both very weak, so... I'll have to see if Elicor can do anything, but he has opted to just back up, but he might get picked up here.
Well, that was a very admirable defense. It's spent the entire time just watching Fred there, hoping that he would go for some huge play, but He took a long time to kind of get to the fight, and by the time he got there, he just got the minor little cleanup kills. So, but you know, it's Gullywash, baby. Maybe you just need 5 versus 6, and you'll still win out on those last defenses. But it's worked out in the end for them. They're going to push out, get the 3 second point, and think about making this mid push in with a full uber charge advantage as well. And this time, Honey Badger isn't anywhere close to getting that his uber charge. So, oh, Domo, nice little air shot there. And Pred is trying to get out from this choke area. Oh, he will go down. So they've lost 2 soldiers from that team. That's a huge margin of the wall if they want to push them away from this. They actually decided to pop in the uber aggressively. Warped is trying to get on top of the Demoman and the medic. He will take out both. He's actually taken out 3 players so far. So they have got a back cap in the shape of Inns, however, to kind of turn things around. But that's just too late. Provided way too much cap time on that midpoint from the 3 out of 6 squad, so they will finally walk away with a mid unscathed.
Yeah, absolutely. That was a good play from 3 out of 6, and I mean, 5 minutes left in this map. I think they're this is a good opportunity here to tie this up. They have to go. I suppose they have to make good use of this uber advantage that they have. If they could pick up a round right now, that would be a real confidence booster for the rest of this map. And I mean, who knows, we could see another quick round after this, but they will be making their way up here into this river area. But Ince, with that headshot onto Warped, but I think 3 out of 6 are just going to maybe hold for now. I think they probably should go with this uber. Tegu will just get it right now, so it looks like Pred will want to get in here. They do have this heavy, though. Now they will prop the uber. They bring this in right now, both soldiers jumping around, trying to get some frags, but it looks like he's just going to play for the points, and it's a lot of frags here. GS and Crayon going down, followed by Degu. So, you know, that's another failed push here for 3 out of 6. And Pred getting picked up at the end, so it will just be Warped getting out. But Honey Badger did go down also, so that might be the only saving grace, because they will more or less equal uber charges.
That was a very desperate push coming in from Degu. Maybe the... not Degu. 3 out of 6 in general. It looked, you could see the cogs turning almost. They were like, okay, we're going to uber in our soldier immediately, and we're just going to get to their high ground. And then the heavy denied him. It was like, it's not working. Plan B, go to the point. Oh no, they're down here as well. Oh god, and we've died. And Warp just turned back from his dead respawn. It's like, hey guys, what's going... Oh, you're all dead.
Yeah, absolutely. But looks like 3 out of 6 are kind of hanging around this big door area. Demo's trying to lead the way for his team, but he's fallen very weak. He will manage to be saved by his medic, and Deox will be picked up, but it looks like 3 out of 6 are able to pick up a couple of frags here. And it looks like Honey Badger and Elicor are kind of getting surrounded here. I mean, Kildart is also here to help, but at the moment it looks like they have to pop off this uber, so Deku will have his as well. This is a bit of a weird situation. They finally have used it, and surely 3 out of 6 will be able to take this.
This is a bit of a very mixture of players there. I had to kind of look at the map for a second. It's like, which half of the map are we on right now? Because all the teams just seem to be scrambled. I don't know who's the defending team or the attacking team, but I guess eventually 3 out of 6 just had their uber popped a little bit later, and that allowed them to win the scrambled mess of a fight. And 3 out of 6 wow. have just played off the chaos again. Yeah. Well, I say again, some team has played off the chaos again, and it's led to another round. So the more structured TF2 gets, the slower it gets, but the more chaotic it gets, the more rounds they'll get. So, simple formula. Let's see if they can make the equation again.
Yeah, for sure. We're coming up here to our third mid-fight. Both teams rolling out to this big door, and we do have 2 minutes left. The team could take a quick round here, but at the moment, Zesty getting really fast there into a 3 out of 6's choke, but Crayon will be the first to fall. I think Domo and Pred are behind. They could make something happen, but Coldheart getting a nice air shot there, so it will deny the aggression from the soldiers. So 3 out of 6 on the back foot again. It looks like Deox actually might get picked up here, and he will. So Degu will get out with his uber charge. But I think Lemmings aren't going to wait around for either medic to get an uber charge, perhaps, as Honey Badger will have a slight advantage. They might just want to bring this in.
I hope they are going straight off the dot. They haven't had a chance to set up a defense on last because they threw so many players at them to try and take Honey Badger down, and they're desperately trying to chase the Crayon kill. They've really been bullying him throughout this entire round so far, and they're keeping their numbers just slightly higher. Degu, though, he's the one that's actually cleaning people up. No way!
Oh my god,
if he got the kill on the Sorix, that would have been absolutely disgusting, but Yeah, it's just a very, very questionable place coming out of 3 out of 6 on that. Maybe not just the mid, but the second point as well. It seemed that when they lost Crayon at the start, they went like, "Well, this mid is shit. Let's just everyone back out and maybe let's throw a few players at Honey Badger, see if like we've got a tide turning pick." But the tide turning pick never came. They just lost so many players. They lost Deox as well, and from that, they didn't have a chance to set up a last defend.
Yeah, for sure, and it worked out pretty well, but they were nearly clutching the round there. But I think we do have 30 seconds left on the map. I think it might be possible, but they have to cap these points so fast. They haven't won this mid fight, so they are just going to get all the way forward. But Turbo, it's not looking too good here for 3 out of 6. His Pred gets picked up. We'll be capping out this second at the moment. 15 seconds left. They're going to have to get it to last pretty much right now.
No, yeah, they have to leave one player behind if they ever want to make a play for this. Yeah, they've done so now, but they should be capping that last point. That second point should be capped as well. They're going in with the Uber, but Honey Badger's got his Uber very, very soon, so yeah, it's not
any time.
Stretch of the imagination.
Indeed, the time will run out. That's unfortunate, but yeah, it looks like Lemmings were able to edge out a 2-1 win.
That was a close game, though, Frisk. I thought it would... Oh, wait, no, I changed my mind, didn't I? Yeah, I... 3 out of 6, I thought they were going to have a bit of a runaway with this, but, you know, shortcomings, a bit of a throw at the end almost, if you had to ask me, but I guess they kept the composure on Lemmings, and you did walk away with this prediction.
I think, you know, even though I did say Lemmings would win this, I thought they'd maybe win it a little bit more comfortably than 2-1 in the final minutes of the map. So I think, you know, that who knows if that's affected them in any way, you know, maybe Lemmings thought that after such a strong performance the other day against Champ GG, maybe they were expecting to pick up this map pretty comfortably against 3 out of 6, but at the moment I think we should take a look at some logs.
Well, I guess I was right in the sense that it is a favourable map for the Roaming Soldier, and Pred, he has turned up a little bit, I suppose. I can't really say it all the way because his team didn't win in the end, but maybe it's just the bag is just way too heavy to carry. And he is toppling at the top with top damage, so it goes to show that he's contributing a lot for his team, at least.
Yeah, for sure. Pred and Domo, the soldiers for 3 out of 6, turning up with top damage. Dying quite a lot, though. But I guess...
It's Roman's life.
Indeed. I think Elcor, you know, he played a good game, but did die quite a lot. In comparison to Deox, I suppose. I mean, it's not a huge difference in deaths, but I suppose a game centered around the soldiers, would you say, Turbo?
Yeah, I would say so. I think a bit of a difference maker as well was just maybe... I don't know. I can't come up with nothing. I was kind of hoping I would have it. My brain would figure it out by now, but I look back at the whiteboard sitting above my netbook with the stats on, and it's telling me I don't know anything about TF2. So,
Yeah, well,
I guess if I had to pin something, anything, maybe it would be the differences between the medics. I think the Ubers of Honey Badger were just slightly better than Daegu's in the end. It just looked like just smidgen a bit better for Honey Badger's Ubers.
Yeah, I'd agree with you. I think I can recall two or three times when Daegu, he wanted to bring the Uber charge into mid, but they would just drop a few players before they would even get their Uber. And I mean, I don't think they played off of advantages as much as maybe they should have, but, you know, in the end, regardless, it was still a pretty close game. Lemmings, though, were able to snatch a quick round just there at the end of the game. So, I suppose medics, the medics and the soldiers of that game were the center point. But I think we do have some more advanced logs on the stream at the moment. I think the first thing that jumps out to me is that, I mean, a lot of frags happening on both of these teams' last points. I think 3 out of 6 were a bit on the back foot for a lot of the first half of the map, and it's the first round as well. The first round was 50 minutes long. That's, you know, it's always tough, Turbo, for a team to just, you know, be so tense for 15 minutes until somebody gets around. I think it was maybe a bit imbalanced towards 3 out of 6. I think a lot of the fighting was on their side of the map.
Yeah, I think it came down to those mid fights as well. I looked at those mid fight stats, and the majority were favouring the Lemmings. So when they won that mid, they could kind of snowball that into this linchpin hold where they couldn't really push out from last that much over on 3-6. And if they did push out from last, it was kind of one of those push-outs where they get the cap for a little bit and then they suddenly lose it again back to the way of Lemmings. So maybe these mid-fights were just a huge priority for Lemmings and they did walk away with that. Maybe a credit to the scouts as well. I think Lemmings Inns was having a particularly good game, which is not something you see every day when you've got a player like Sorex as your counterpart.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, that's going to be Gullywash. I think we're going to be looking at Granary next. Do you think 3-6 with a close game, they could find it within themselves to pick up Granary?
Usually this map comes down to who has the best soldiers, maybe even the Demon Man, if he's having a scream of a game, as a say in the matter. But classically, if we just look at who has the strongest soldiers on these teams, we'll usually walk away with it. And because Domo and Pred were doing a sizable amount for their team to kind of contribute to the damage and whatnot, just make me think that their head is in the game a little bit. But yeah, I'm gonna have to again go with the prediction of 3-6 for this map. If I had to pin myself towards any sort of team, I think Domo and Pred combined will be just a little bit stronger than Zesty and Coldheart. But who knows, maybe Elicor, as I can remember, having a pretty brief breakout game in the, I think it was the qualifiers for the Prem. And I think when they were playing against the final game of the entire qualifier, it was on this Granary map where Elicor had such a smashing success that maybe he might be able to recapture that again.
Yeah, I do remember that. That was the preseason playoffs final. And yeah, Lemmings were able to come up on top with that, and I think that was attributed to Elicor just going huge on this map. So, I mean, I certainly will be keeping my eye on Elicor, but I'm going to just go with Lemmings again for this map. However, seeing that first map, I mean, obviously this map can go anyway, but I think it could be close again. I mean, you said it's maybe down to the soldiers to turn up here, but I think Pred and Domo did play pretty well, so we'll have to see how these soldiers fare on this map.
Also keep in mind that there won't be any pesky sniper play as much on this map. Maybe a shy of the gimmick ones, like the forward respawn, for example, or maybe the last points, because after all it is the last point, there's going to be snipers there, but they won't be able to run as many snipers as, you know, on these mids or, you know, second points, for example, because the map's just so big, Fisk. These, you know, these off-classes just take such a long time to get to where they want to go, so you don't really see as many off-classing as you'd like to see. If it was like a low panda game, I'd feel sorry for a flex player around about now.
Yeah, for sure, but I mean, if both these teams, or if either of these teams do feel like they want to run some off-classes, we could see the game maybe slow down a little bit. I know Granary can be notorious for stalemates, but hopefully not. Hopefully we'll see some good TF2, see some teams actually pushing Turbo Tabs. But yeah, we will be going live soon, so if Turbo, you want to give us a cheeky scoreline.
Oh, I never committed to a scoreline, did I? Again, I'm going to go with the meme. It'll be a 6-3 rounds for 3-6.
All right, I think I'll go for a 3-1 for Lemmings, but we have gone live. If you are just joining us, this is ETF2L Premiership Season 26, Week 6. This is Lemmings versus 3-6, as we see both these devil men arrive to mid. Deox considerably weaker, but it looks like Elicor was unable to maybe get an early sticky spam there, so they will just try and exchange the spam at the moment as the rest of the teams will roll out to this left side of their map. So it's a lot of spam here from Demo here on this crate area, but Zesty and Coldheart want to go in right now, but Coldheart just gets destroyed here by Crayon. But a lot of 3-6 is weak, but Zesty going down as well. They do have the picks. Pred is still in. He might actually pick up Sorex as well, so this is looking pretty good here for 3-6. They can just clean up the frags, and Elicor might get caught out here. He tried to sticky jump away. He's 18 in health, but he will manage to leave for the time being.
well done to 3 out of 6 for holding on against the aggression of Lemmings there, while Pred tried to make his wraparound, his kind of mini flank as a roaming soldier, and paid off in the end there. He allowed him to get into a position where he could catch a few players off guard and start being the I guess initial pick for that mid to start dominoing from there.
Yeah, for sure. But at the moment, I mean, it's pretty much the same thing what happened last map. There was pretty much immediately a bit of a stalemate, but I mean, 3 out of 6 are holding a little bit passively on mid. It doesn't look like they want to take anything, any sort of ubercharged trade at the moment, and of course, no off-classes right now, as you were saying. Probably wouldn't see that, but Crayon did just go in for something, but will get picked up.
Now, this just tells me that Crayon does want to get the off-class. I don't think he was really expecting to get the pick onto Honey Badger there as a scout, just walking in. And they're not going to rest on their laurels here over on...
Oh, Zesty! Wow, nice air shot from Zesty onto Domo. He just jumped in, picked him up above the crates.
And survived.
And he actually will just bring this in for his team. Wow, that's gotta hurt, as the rest of 3 out of 6 are just gonna fall back out to their yard.
Keep in mind as well, the suicide of Crayon in, so while he might have been alive for that initial bomb in, he was from practically a different map away from his team, so he couldn't really contribute to any sort of defense there, so it was wise of 3 out of 6 to back out there.
Yeah, for sure. But yeah, we will see another small stalemate as these teams decide exactly what they want to do. I mean, Turbo, at this point, how do you think a team should go about this push into yard? Should they take it through this ramp frame, or
invest their soldiers in? Invest all heal stocks into Zesty right now. He's on fire. He's going in. He wants the air shot.
Oh, it's out. If he had hit that, and I think he did hear you talk, he'd send those heals to Zesty. But it didn't work out, so Elicor and Zesty will be dead right now for Lemmings. Demo looking to create some space for his team. Dios jumping in as well. The Ubercharge will be popped here from Honey Badger. Dios getting his off as well. So it looks like 3 out of 6 might have the upper hand here. They have better positioning right
Everyone's
now.
Everyone's got a dedicator on Lemmings now if they want to ever make this fight go any sort of bit. Oh wow, what a dedication! Oh my god, they're falling to pieces. They're just made out of biscuits and cream. Ooh.
Yeah, and tasty. I think it was Domo who was behind in ramp room onto Honey Badger, but he gave him the jukes and he manages to get out. But Lemmings going to be able to get in here on the second, and we'll have a uber advantage to work with to take to last.
What a play coming in from Honey Badger there. What a call. He's just said, like, let's use the uber and defend this because we're going to have the respawns on their side. And the respawners did eventually come, and they did a good job of collapsing, dedicating themselves in. They even get this nice slow push going. They don't even allow them to set up the defense, get mentally prepared after that little blitz of a push there. And they're going to get the first round on the board, Frisk. Even a feel-good uber for Honey Badger. Well played.
Yeah, absolutely. That was just really, really good from Lemmings. They used that. They just played that so well. So, yeah, I mean, I suppose a confident push there to last, and the first round will go to Lemmings, so we'll have to see what kind of response 3 out of 6 will be able to make as we go to our second mid-fight, Turbo.
Alright, so the first thing I'm going to watch in this mid is see if Elicor will catch out Deox in this mid, but he decides to go push out top instead, a little bit of a safer route compared to his last venture on that last mid point, but they should be aware to press
traits.
Okay, only Badger down, so they just need to protect Daegu now to make sure they control this mid point, but he's brought down very, very low.
That's incredible. I'm not sure because I didn't see very well, but I think Daegu managed to save himself from cratering by wall bugging on one of those roundy walls beside his the round walls beside the left hand of his mid. That was crazy, but I've never seen it before, but I think he was able to wall bug.
Yeah, I think if there's like a diagonal surface, you can wall bug on it.
Yeah, but that was a bit of a strange mid as well, as Honey did get picked up pretty much immediately, so the 3 out of 6 will be able to surely do something here on this last push. But Honey has that Vaccinator, and that is always a good choice here when you don't have an Ubercharge, so 3 out of 6 walking in on this right-hand side, being met with a lot of spam as they are trying to walk in here. Finally will pop the Supercharge, a lot of time on point here by the Scout, and finally will be blocked at the moment. But they have managed to get the picks. Heavy has just stood on the point, and they're going to have to take him down before they can do anything. I think, yeah, this surely will be a last hold for Lemmings, as Daegu is just trying to do something, but just hits his skill bind. So, yeah, successful last hold.
They just didn't have enough damage there, Chris. You could see them desperately trying to pluck away at them, but the blob was just too big, and it had a fat resistance on it as well. So, what is a player to do over on 3 out of 6 if they've just got so much health to chew through? I think they had the right idea. They wanted to push in greedily with it and maybe play off the fact that Vaccinator isn't dishing out those buffs as well, so they're a tiny bit susceptible to that spam, and they had a nice multiing effort going in from Honey Badger there, popping bubbles off left, right and centre, but it just lost too many players, picked off in the end due to that heavy weapons guy and the fight just being extended out.
Yeah, for sure, 3 out of 6. Certainly not going to be happy about that. They did have that Uber Charge advantage, but again, I think this Vaccinator hold can be very effective, and Honey Badger proving that he can use that Vaccinator pretty well, so looks like Lemmings will want to just work their way into this ramp room area as Mel gets launched completely high into the air, and looks like 3 out of 6 might just have to fall back out here. There's a lot of weak players, but Daegu trying to get in and giving some heals to his team, but Will's get picked up by Mel, so many weak players right now for 3 out of 6, and surely Lemmings will be able to clean this up.
Yeah, they're being brave because they have to. They're going to have to find that pick on the Honey Badger, but they will bring him down low enough, but not quite low enough that he'll die, so Honey Badger will live to tell another tale and hold on to that 50% advantage he's got, and it looks like they're about ready to push into this last point as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're going.
Yeah, they are. They're just going to try and get this in. It looks like Ince is just so far forward. He takes a lot of damage. Might get picked up here. Will, it's will be a trade with Wirt, but they are just going to try and play this point. Elkhorn very weak, but yeah, Will get a really good sticky there. So it's a bit of a messy fight at the moment, as the rest of Lemmings will just be able to use these heals surely to pick up this round.
Yeah, look at them. The heals are just winning the fight for them so much. With Daegu going down, he really is a priority for 3 out of 6 if you want to hold on to these last points for these extended amounts of time. So, easy second round for Lemmings there. This is going to be their cushy round, the one that makes them feel a bit confident that they're not going to lose the game.
Yeah, well, I mean, anything can happen here. We are going to our third mid-fight, and if you are just joining us, this is ETF2L Season 26 Premiership Week 6, Lemmings versus 3 out of 6, as we see both MMM make their way to mid, exchanging some stickies over this point, as they wait for the rest of their team to take some positioning.
Oh, scout rush! He's going on today, Deox, but it's a jibated.
Indeed.
As Inns will go down, and Deox does get picked off in the end, but they've lost Honey Badger over on Lemmings here, so they just need to... Oh, actually, no, I flicked over, and they've also lost Daegu during the fight, and it's just been a big scrappy mess. It's hoping that the DM and the, the coordination on Lemmings will win the round for them, and it will win the mid at least. So a midpoint will go to the side of Lemmings once again.
Yeah, absolutely, and I think, 3 out of 6, I'm not sure if they've won a mid fight yet. You know, that's, you know, they're two rounds down. Winning a mid would certainly be a big boost to confidence, they would have needed.
I think they definitely won a mid. I think they won that mid against Honey Badger,
I think it was, I don't know what I'm talking about. I think they actually won one or two mids, but they will look to make their way into the yard at the moment. Sorex taking a little bit of a fight with Pred, but I think the Uber is pretty much equal. I think Honey Badger will have to wait and see if he will realize they do have an advantage, but Daegu is coming up shortly on his Uber Charge. But
is that a Chris Krieg?
I'm not entirely sure, but
yeah, it's a Chris Krieg on Honey Badger.
Oh wow, we might see some fat crits in on Elakor. Well, that's a bit of a strange crit. I don't think they saw anybody, but
I think that's where you're just trying to be surprising with the crits, and they just thought they have to be around here. They can't really get an eye around without, giving away position or giving away that they have the crits play coming in. So if they thought they just go around the corner immediately with this crits, they might catch out the medic there. But Daegu is better positioned than that. So they're going to prey off the fact that crits flopped so hard. But Honey Badger's kept himself alive and he's built the crits very quickly. Good God. So he's going to have another crits raring to go. And raw remnants of 3 out of 6 still left in this lobby area. They're probably going to have to give up that this second point for 3 though, and we've got a bit of a headache to deal with when it comes to this crit screen going to last. They've actually thrown in a few players to try and... I don't know who they were trying to pick off there. I'm already positioning my camera on last.
Yeah, for sure. I think Pred was trying to get onto the medic, but Sorex will just pad his stats, already has 4 dominations, and
nice bomb from Dermo. He's just bammed out that choke that they tried to push from the top area, the only place you could realistically get a nice crits from. So they take out Honey Badger as well as a bonus kill for Dermo there, so Dermo kind of saving them out for them.
Yeah, that was incredible. Really good defense. Dermo basically picking up 2 kills there, so looks like Lemmings be on the back foot as Diggy will have a bit of an advantage to work with, and 3 out of 6 will be making their way into mid at the moment. There's a bit of a fight happening here between Crayon and I think that's Ince here, but it's quite far forward, so it will get picked up, and that's a nice frag to have as you're trying to get into mid here. But Diggy gets picked up by Elicor. Not sure if that was a trap or not. I think it was, and that's just a disaster here for 3 out of 6. So they will be able to play these heals.
Yeah, but their position's horrible out of Lemmings, so they don't want to stay in, even though they are incredibly tempted to, because they have got the respawners on the slide. So they want to push in with just the heals alone, now that they've got a few more members of Lemmings alive, and they've sent Dermo in to try and make some magic happen again, but he's not going to find the pick onto Honey Badger, so the mid won for 3 out of 6, and the mid lost for 3 out of 6.
Yeah, that was all down to Elicor picking up the drop onto Daegu. He had a sticky trap just beside the health pack. I think Elicor really likes that sticky trap. If I do recall, he has used that before on Granary and has had similar results in dropping medics, but at the moment Pred is in this lunchbox area and he will get picked up, so they will have this frag to work with. Daegu only coming up in about 50% at the moment. He will just be running Medigun, no Vaccinator in sight, so it will bring this in right now, so the Uber Charge will be popped. Sentry Gun going down, but it will pick up Mel, so I mean, Honey Badger's Uber hasn't been as successful as maybe they'd hoped, but it's just the scouts here for 3 out of 6, and they're trying their hardest, but soldiers will just be able to pick up the frags.
I noticed that a scout was focusing down Honey... was it Honey Badger? Or was it Daegu? Wait, actually no, I don't know who was focusing down, because at the end there, I think Honey Badger was still alive, so... I just saw a scout not focusing on the right target. I think if he just focused on the other targets that were alive, they wouldn't be overwhelmed so much by those last couple of numbers towards the tail end of that last push. But, you know, c'est la vie, it's another round, Fisk.
Yeah, for sure. As you see, Fred going for a really high jump there, and he will pick up that demo man, but meanwhile, Zesty trying to get behind, trying to get some damage onto Diggy. So it looks like Lemming's trying to break out of this. Diok's getting launched so high up in the air, he's quite weak, will get picked up. So pretty convincing mid for Lemmings.
Again, it's just coming up Lemmings. They are dominating on this Granary map. Maybe 3 out of 6 aren't good when it comes to these new maps that get entered into the rotation. They need some time to get, you know, their groove onto these maps.
New maps, Turbo, this is Granary. This is 2007 territory.
Yeah, but you need a week buffer to kind of remind yourself what everybody wants to do on this map.
Yeah, perhaps. But right now, though, we do see Elicor trying to peek into this to the second point. Looks like 3 out of 6 will be able to wait as well on this point, but Zesty is running the spy, so I'm not sure if Fleming's going to just wait around and wait for Zesty 360.
They're not going to expect the spy here. He takes such a long time to get into position on Granary, and... Oh, he's got that!
Oh,
he's with the stab!
It.
The sticky bombs!
How does he do it? How do you miss the easy stab? Oh, Zesty, well, we can't really fault him because he's been playing really good sword in this game, but it looks like 3 out of 6...
Maybe he thought it was like, you know, Call of Duty, where you just lunge towards your player once you've got him in your sights.
Perhaps at the moment.
I think he was just so happy to see a medic like in front of his screen that he was just smashing the fire button. He's like, oh no, this is a melee weapon, not a ranged weapon.
Oh no, I'm not playing soldier. but yeah, at the moment, Crayon did go down, so. I mean, Lemmings, do you think. Oh, it's 15 minutes left. I was going to say that they want to play the point, but that would be a little bit page out of Seven's playbook, but. It looks like they might want to take this frag onto the soldier in lunchbox, but Sol falling so weak, that was Pred, but Zesty actually will get picked up, maybe overextending it a little bit, so 3 out of 6 might be able to contest this, but they do have so many weak players, so I think Lemmings will be able to get in here. Demo is in Z, and he will be getting flanked by Sorex, so... But, he actually will bring the Ubercharge in, so that's a bit of a, maybe strange decision from Daegu, as the Ubercharge wasn't that good, but they will be able to just reset on last.
Yeah, and nobody's capping off the point. I thought they were getting them now that they've pushed 3 out of 6 successfully. Pred is behind, though, and he's going for the huge wraparound. He's on top of Honey Badger, but he will survive. He gets the nice surf on the second rocket, keeping himself alive. And I don't think Pred had enough rockets in there. He had to dedicate himself to speed more so than firepower. So he didn't have enough rockets in his rocket launcher to actually finish off Honey Badger. Oh, Zesty!
Yeah, Zesty was in super early. He managed just to pick up Deok, so that will just pave the way for the rest of his team to play this point. They have a little bit of time, but they have to deal with these 3 out of 6 players first, and it seems to be working out very well as they're all quite weak, and they surely will be able to pick up these frags, but they do have the supercharge. Honey Badger has about 100% right now, so surely Sorex will be able to just do what he does best and take these scouts, and looks like Honey Badger wants to play this point. He will pick up Crayon and pistol down Daegu and pick up the fourth round for Lemmings.
Well, if I had 4 dominations there, I would not have gone for that play. I would have been like, no, save my doms, I don't want to die. But Sorex, he's a bigger man than me. He took the solo Uber and took out 1, 2, and 3 players on that final last point. Hold on to Sorex, manning up there.
Sorex showing that confidence he has in his DM ability, but it's not looking too good for 3 out of 6. It's 4-0 here, but it's going down almost immediately. Eloqua getting picked up as well, so this is pretty strong mid so far right now for 3 out of 6. And it looks like Zesty wants to build for something again, but will be picked up by Domo.
Yeah, they just forced everybody on that left-hand side and just bumbushed a good 3 or 4 players on that scout, and then suddenly a Demoman was in front of their face as well, so they just got that 3D. And Sorex is caught off in a random place there. Oh no, Doms have surely been lost. Yes, he's lost one already. Rest in peace.
Yeah, but right now there's a Uber popped on the point. Daegu will try to get a bit of a better Uber charge here, and it looks like Warps will try and push in to Honey Badger here, but nothing has really happened with that Uber charge, and 3 out of 6 are 2 players down. Deox and Warp getting picked up as well, so not very good here for 3 out of 6 as Daegu will make his way to safety at mid.
I mean, he did keep himself alive, but it's such a long time for him to reconnect with another player that he won't really salvage any percentage because of it. So they're going to get this midpoint for free over on Lemmings. They've got about 25%, actually no, yeah, about 30% is probably a better margin for Honey Badger to make this push onto second as well, but they want to take this fight into yard area, it seems, on 3 out of 6, not giving it away for free, but needs to keep in the back of their mind that Honey Badger will have his Uber up very, very soon.
Yeah, absolutely. You can only have about 80% right now. I mean, Honey Badger? Maybe they're not aware of the...
Are you guys pushing? Any second?
And they are. They've Ubered this Eloqua demo. He's jumped in, trying to get something done. No frags happening just yet. His Deox gets picked up on the edge. Daegu going down as well. In the midst of that, he got caught in. So many weak players right now. Warped as well. It's just Crayon. Lam coming out from Eloqua. So, well, that's a complete
wipe. Uber.
And I think that, will just be the end of Granary Turbo.
Yeah, I think they forgot that Uberchargers were a thing for a second there on 3 out of 6. They... So maybe a bit surprised by how much ground Elecor can, I guess, cover. And because it was one of those shutter doors as well, it's very difficult to get out over on 3 out of 6. So once they dedicated themselves in, Daegu thought, well, I might as well dedicate myself in with the team as well, because this can't lose that many players, but they ended up doing anyway. So quick 5-0 for the Lemon squad. That's quite a different tale to our first map.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, unfortunately for 3 out of 6, they just weren't able to get any momentum going in that map, but I don't think I was expecting a 5-0 roll, but there you have it, folks. I think Gem might be able to pull up some logs on stream, and the first thing I see is, I mean, because the game is so short, it's a little bit lower damaging than you'd expect, but I think again the soldiers of 3 out of 6
Oh
turning up,
my
not bad, but
God, look at that kill difference between Sorex and his desk. Whew. He is sitting
Sorex.
at just your atypical 19 point oh kill assist death ratio.
That's standard, man, for Sorex. That's just no bother. But yeah, Sorex, wow. Incredible stuff.
Man, wow. I mean, I was pointing out his domination throughout the game, but I never realized that his deaths were that low. But oh, baby, sorry, I've kind of taken over the entire log segment. I just go like, look at Sorex, but look at him. He's just proving that this is not a... Again, I'm gonna go back to the whiteboard. I don't know anything about Team Fortress 2. I say this is a soldier map, so it gets 27 kills and 2 deaths. I'm just gonna underline it a bit more. There we go.
Yeah, for sure. Sorex, and I mean, he did that all on 50% heals. Not bad, I suppose. But yeah, Sorex turning up big, along with the rest of his team. I mean, what caused such a role, Turbo? What was the problem in Granary?
I'm trying to think. There was just a variety of reasons, really. There wasn't like one pure. I guess you could just say Sorex was the problem,
Sorry for the problem.
but I think there was like I think the first round they Zesty got a nice kind of bomb onto Daegu. I think that was sticking in my mind. Or no, you got the bomb actually onto Domo to kind of just pull back this mid. Stalemate, so that kind of turned the tides from there. The last points have been kind of weird. The defenses for 3 out of 6, they haven't been stellar or great, and maybe the DM is showing a bit more on Lemmings as well. I could remember that there would be some quite even fights between them, and then suddenly Lemmings would just edge out towards the longer fights, especially on the last point as well. Springs to my mind,
Yeah, for
but
sure.
yeah, it can't be the mids. I was just thinking that it can, maybe it was the mids, but no, they're about even when it comes to who took the mids away. So it wasn't the snowballing effect. It was just, oh my God, that's a lot of blue. But yeah, what do you expect from a 5-0? I mean,
Yeah, like Sorex and Zesty were just playing pretty well. And I do see Zesty in Twitch chat. Zesty, hello, you absolute legend. But yeah, we do see some advanced logs at the moment on stream. I mean, blue. All I see is blue turbo.
Wow, that's actually very, very strange. They spent the majority of time over on the Lemmings last. I don't remember that.
I'm not entirely sure about that, but yeah, I mean, looking at this conversion rate, Lemmings were just had some really effective last pushes. And I mean, when a team can just push last like that, have some really good pushes, so I mean,
It
maybe
looks
a
like they
5-0
couldn't.
is all you could see.
It looks like they couldn't crack their second point either. They only had one a actual time that they got that second point over on 3 out of 6, while Lemmings had plenty advantage times to take a crack at it. So I guess. Oh wow, that is a lot of vengeance on that board. Sorex showing that there will be no pred action throughout the entire game, denying him well over 8 times. And Sorex has actually got himself onto the board 4 times. He's just one player short of getting all the DM classes on the enemy team.
Yeah, all I see is just Sorex, Sorex,
Alright, so looking at the. Oh wow, these the Ubers were quite telling for Lemmings as well. They got 20 kills compared to 3 out of 6's mere 6 kills, so they're doing everything right with their Ubers, it seems, over on the Lemmings squad. And even the post kills post Uber as well were very, very flashy.
Yeah.
So maybe my conclusion from the first map was better suited to the second map. The Ubers just seem to be better as well.
Yeah, for sure. But we do have some players from Lemmings. We have Ince and Mel in Bumble at the moment. Maybe they can give some insight. First of all, guys, congratulations. a bit of a close map on Gullywash, but you seem to just have it sorted out on Granary. I mean, Gullywash, were you expecting such a close game?
Not really, to be honest. Cesty and me didn't got on this game at all. I was like not sticking to Aiden all the time, and Aiden died. It was like a bit unfortunate, and we didn't play that well on Gully. Granary was far better.
So,
I kind of disagree here because I felt pretty confident and I felt pretty good playing Gullywash. I guess that's due to the fact that I'm finally back on Pocket Scout, and Sorix is playing Aggressive Scout, and that's what we both prefer. I just realized that I'm not pretty good at Aggressive Scout, so yeah, anyway, we switched roles and
It worked really well, yeah.
yeah, it's working really
Yeah,
well.
really, yeah, just a little bit. So, if you guys were, it sounds like Inns, you prefer Pocket Scout to, compared to Aggressive Scout, and it sounds like Sorix prefers Aggressive Scout to Pocket Scout. So, I have to ask, why was it the other way around for such a while?
Well, initially when I joined, I was playing Pocket Scout for a couple of days of scrims, I guess. I think I was playing Pocket Scout during Playoffs for Prem, and at some point we decided to switch it up. I don't know, I don't remember why, honestly, but we decided to switch it up, and I thought I was doing the right thing, but it turned out I was doing like completely stupid stuff sometimes. Like, I wasn't taking enough heals. You can see that our heals are pretty equal, and at the same time, we're doing the different things. And back when I was on Pocket Scout, I used to take like 8%, 9% heals, and Sorix took 20, and I just struggled on flank.
All right, okay. So, I mean, congratulations to both of you for tonight. I noticed that both of the scouts, yes, Inns, you had a very good map on Gullywash, and Sorix had a very, very good map on Granary as well. Do you guys kind of pick up and play off who's having a good game based on the map? Like, do you ever see, like, oh man, Inns is going absolutely huge. Let's just pay off Inns. Let's see what Inns is what wants to do on this map. Or do you just. You still just like listen to a basic plan or something that you've set before the game?
Well, I wish that was a thing because I don't have enough clips for my frag clip XD. But no, we're not really doing this.
Yeah,
Okay.
Aiden's basically main calling.
I mean, speaking of like, I mean, individual performances, Zesty had a really strong game, I think, on both maps, but Granary in particular. I
Maybe not
think.
so much Gullywash. I think he was struggling on Gullywash, actually.
Yeah,
Yeah.
I was sort of, me and Sesty were
Yeah.
really struggling on Gullywash.
But on Granary, is the Zesty Roamer bomb, is that something you play off a lot? I mean, I noticed he was playing really well. Is that something that you just say to Zesty for him to just jump in on his own to try and make something work, or do you maybe prefer to just take in an Uber charge?
It depends which situations we are staying, but mostly we're getting Sesty in to force the medic or get a really nice pick. That's basically our plan. It's like depending which situations.
The mids were very back and forth tonight, I noticed. Were you guys happy with mids at all, or was it 3 out of 6 just seemed to turn up on these mids in particular?
I think we just didn't play together on Gullywash, and yeah, like I said, our sword just didn't got in this game, and it's a really big factor on Gullywash in my opinion, and we couldn't do anything there. So 3 out of 6 played them really well.
All right, so it is week 6 of the 7-week ETF Tour series, and we're kind of winding down to the final parts of the season. Have you guys got any goals left in mind for these remaining couple of weeks? Did you guys think like, oh, maybe we're going to stick together for the next season, or we just want to do better than a particular team, or what are your guys' goals for the final moments of the league?
At the moment, we're planning to stick together. I don't know how it's gonna be for me, like in real life, but if nothing interesting comes up, I will definitely play the next season. So, Yeah, we're definitely gonna keep playing together. And for the as for the girls, like, yeah, we're totally wanna 6-0 Nanya next week. And it's like really unfortunate that we couldn't get the last round on Viaduct last week, because like we actually had a chance to make it to playoffs, and I think we absolutely deserve to be there.
From the improvement side, yeah. Not from the beginning of the season.
Now, I'm not gonna get a chance, I think, maybe next week to interview you guys, so I have to ask now, like, what do you think of your entire season so far as a team? Are you happy with what you've accomplished this season? Or if you had to give me a rating out of 10, how was this like a 10 out of 10 season? Couldn't do any better? Or do you think you could have, yeah, what's your rating on it basically, on your team's performance?
I think it was like solid 7 out of 10 or something, because like the beginning of the season were like really fucking messy, and we played against seven and all the good teams in top five, and we improved really well during the season, and I think we should be like all. Oh yeah, okay, I forgot what I wanted to say.
Yeah,
We
I
should be
agree
all
with.
happy about it, so.
Yeah, I'm also happy about that. I agree with Mel. Solid 8.
Solid 8. So,
Yep.
what about that? Does pique my curiosity slightly. So, if we switch the season around slightly, if you played the top players towards the end of your season, where you were, you would have had this sort of progression with your team. Do you think you would have, if some of these results would have changed? Maybe you would have squeezed the win against seven top five, Cham GG,
Not seven for
and
sure, but
not Cham
maybe
GG when he
top
played them,
five.
but. Yeah.
Maybe top five though.
Yeah, top five. We started winning scrims against them, so we definitely could have taken some points off them. But
Right.
And Arctic Foxes maybe as well.
yeah, Arctic Foxes as well.
Yeah, I just forgot
Oh yeah, I
about
forgot about them
these
as
guys.
well.
Yeah, see you next season.
All right, Frisk, I think I'm all questioned now. I'm not sure about you.
Yeah, I think that's all I have to say for now. But I think since I'm pretty much the end of the season, week six, I certainly will be looking forward to seeing you guys play next season and take all this improving you've been doing forward, and hopefully you'll end up with a better final standings in the Prem table. But yeah, I think for now that's all we have. So of course, I am going to give some shout-outs to you guys, starting with Ince.
Yeah, shout out to my team, of course, especially Sorex. If you're hearing this, I'm a huge fan. Please notice me.
Notice me, senpai.
Shout out to production crew. And of course,
That's us. Yay.
shout out to my boy Pandemic, Japanese boy. I got good.
All right, and Mel, if you want to say anything.
Shout out to my team, of course, and the production. And shout out
Looking.
to and shout out to my jump mates on the jump server.
And Turbo.
Gonna give a big shout out to Jem, the actual production guy. I'm glad that we're lumped together as production people. Get to play off his credit. But a big shout out to Frisk as well, maturing as a caster. As the weeks go by, it's a very humbling moment to see my caster just grow. I'm proud of you, Frisk.
Thank you very much, Trevor.
I'm gonna give a big shout out as well to Mel and Inns for joining us on this interview as well. It's always a nice little spicy addition to a TF2 cast, really tops it off.
Yeah, I'll shout out to 3 out of 6 and Lemmings, two good teams. He had some good games this evening. Yeah, shout out to Jem as well, producing, and Turbo, my co-caster this evening. Shout out to our Twitch viewers as well. But yeah, I think that's all I have to say for now. So be sure to give us a follow on Twitch if you enjoyed this cast. Check us out on Team Fortress TV, on Twitter, and YouTube as well. We upload all our VODs there. But for the time being, that's just going to be all of us here from Team Fortress TV signing off.